Hello and welcome to this video demo. ADS 2011 has some exciting new layout improvements that makes physical design easier than ever. This video highlights the new command line editor. Notice in this design, this gate DC pad is very close to the border. With a simple two-letter command, DY minus 20, I can move this pad down 20 micron and away from the border. I can push into a subnetwork by typing PI, and I can push out of that subnetwork by typing PO. I can zoom in with a 5 times factor by typing ZI5, and I can zoom out 5 times by typing ZO5. Let me now click here to access the list of all the commands. Commands like move, rotate, copy, merge, insert a trace, and many other. Also, page 2 include more commands as shown here. All these commands can be customized according to your preference. The command line editor also comes with a toolbar that contains many of the editing functions. For example, this die area contains 10 unaligned bias pads. Let me select the top 5 and use the align to top command. Next, I use the bottom 5 pads and align them to the bottom of the die area, all in a one mouse click. Another way to use the command line editor is to click on this icon, which opens a command window that you can move and place anywhere you like. This command window allows you to reuse the same command over and over by only using the Enter key. For example, here, using DX50 moves the object again and again by only clicking on the Enter key. Let me use the command RC15, or rotate around the center by 15 degrees. This allows me to reuse this command again and again by clicking on the Enter key. The command line editor toolbar can be dragged and placed anywhere around your layout page. And you can activate this new command line editor from the ADS 2011 main window by clicking on Tools, Manage ADS AEL Add-ons, and enabling it with a check mark. The new command line editor in ADS 2011 helps you edit and complete your layout easily and efficiently. Thank you for watching this video.